I always see people say, hey, Blake, am I too late to have an online resale business? Have I missed the boat? No, the boat is still in the harbor, still taking passengers. And if you're motivated, you can have a successful side income or even replace your full-time income with online resale. As supply chain shortages get worse, as more people become more comfortable with buying things secondhand, as more platforms emerge out of the technological mist, resale is becoming more and more popular every single year. So in this video, we're going to talk about how you can start, because you know what? You can start. So the first thing you're going to want to do is make an account. Before you think about where you're going to store things, before any of this, you have to create an account. That's the first step. It might seem simple, but that first step is what stops so many people. I'm going to link below to the landing pages for all of the account signup processes, but for the most part, they are very easy. For Amazon, it's a bit more arduous. You're going to have an unsecured line of credit. You're going to want to have business insurance. It's going to be $30 or $40 a month, not a lot to worry about. And Amazon will also have, if you want to have a professional account, a monthly fee. But everything else is going to be relatively free to post on. Some platforms might have a listing fee, but for the most part, there's not going to be a monthly recurring fee if you don't want to have it. The next step is list the things around you. Don't even go out and buy stuff, because when you first start selling, what is more difficult than knowing what to sell is just becoming acclimated with the app. So on Amazon, you want to see how to list something from your phone. On Etsy, if you want to do that, you want to figure out how to write a good description. If you're on Amazon, that's a whole different animal. If you're on Mercari, that's an easier workflow. But you want to get familiar with this, because if you want to have recurring, reliable, passive income or side income, you're going to have to become familiar with how these platforms work. So just get your phone out, download the apps, and play with it. Don't treat this as a very difficult thing. Don't worry about messing up or making your listing wrong or choosing the wrong category. If you make a mistake, that's okay. Just learn from it. What's most important is you continue these gradual steps. Make an account, list something. Once you do that 10 or 25 times, that's when you'll become more knowledgeable. And you'll be able to look around you and see, oh, this is how much things cost in my area. Here's when I can really start scaling up my business. And that brings us to our next step, which is understand what a profit actually is. Again, these things might seem simple, but you have to visualize everything you see around you and all the stuff you list as potential profit. So a book will ship less than a giant Nintendo 64. A book on Amazon will have more fees than food items. There's tons of things like that you have to become well acquainted with. And so what I'd recommend doing is start off on one platform first. Let's talk about eBay or Mercari. Those are two very simple ones that will go as if we are listing on those. My process for both platforms is I want to look up an item by its name, by the keywords I would use. Keywords are going to be something as simple as the model number or what it's being used for. So let's say I'm selling a VCR. I'll say Samsung VCR model number DF25 or whatever it is. If it's a Christmas stocking, I'm not going to say Briarwood Gray Fish Christmas Appliance. I'm going to say Kids Shark Christmas Stocking, something like that. If it's Valentine's Day candy, I might not say the random brand I got from Dollar Tree. I might say Valentine's Day, Sweetest Day, Gift Bundle, things like that. Look up keywords like that, because you want to see two things, three things, kind of, if we're being really specific. You want to figure out what the market price is, what the sell-through rate is, and along with the sell-through rate, what the price things are selling at is. Just seeing things listed at a certain price does not mean they sell, and just seeing things sell at a certain price does not mean the market price currently is that. Everything is constantly changing, so you want to have as much information as you can to make an informed decision on what you will charge for your item. On eBay, very simple. You just scroll down, click sold listings. You can see how many sold. You go back to unsold listings, sort by lowest price, buy it now. That gives you a great idea of both what the market sale price is and the market list price is. On Mercari, a little bit different. They're more chronologically populating in terms of their search results, but you can still see what sold recently and how many are currently for sale. That information is gold to anyone who resells. You can't just go off your best guess. You have to figure out what the market actually can hold. After you figure out what the item is worth, you're going to figure out how to ship it. Now, what I recommend for beginners is pick small things, pick media. So books, DVDs, CDs, stuff like that. Video games are not media mail, but they are small. Anything under 16 ounces will ship first class mail. And that's going to vary from like $4 to $6, depending on where it goes in the country. Anything over 1 pound that is not media is most likely going to ship priority mail. USPS offers parcel select, but priority mail is going to be your best bet in most cases, unless the item is large. I'd say more than 5 pounds, more than a foot by a foot by a half a foot. Then most likely, at least in my experience, FedEx or UPS will be your best bet. Now, the good thing is on eBay, you can buy either UPS or USPS postage direct from the app. It will take from your sales. On Mercari, they're going to offer you options, or you can do what I do and you can just ship on your own. I use a service called Pirate Shipper, and I have found that they have better rates than Mercari does. However, here's the catch. If you don't buy shipping off of eBay or Mercari, you're going to have a harder time having an insurance claim if the package potentially gets lost. Again, that's small stuff. Don't worry about it in the short run, but in the long run, it will end up helping you make more money overall. So we've made our accounts. We've understood the apps. We've found our items, the price they're going to ship for, and how we're going to ship it. Once you've made that listing filled with rich keywords based on things people are looking for, based on pertinent information about the item, and it sells, then what? Well, then you ship the item. Ta-da! Look at all this stuff now. So quite literally, all I use to ship out stuff is boxes from Lowe's like this, bubble wrap I bought from Lowe's, and these bubble mailers I got from Walmart. These were on sale for like, I think 98 cents for 15 for a while. But if you don't want to spend money on shipping supplies, you can just find them for free in recycling bins. It's not difficult at all. But these are going to be the main types of things that you're going to have to ship. So this is the first thing. It's a kid's toy. It's a Fisher-Price kid's remote. It sold for $20 on Amazon. Literally, it just goes in here, and then on this side, I have the postage there. Very simple, very easy, not difficult to do. This is a plush doll, Chicago Bulls plush doll. I sold for $40. It just goes in a poly mailer like this, a plastic poly mailer. I bought it in a 1,000-pack on Amazon. You can buy a 10-pack or a 100-pack on eBay. Very affordable. I put it in here, and like plush stuff or T-shirts or anything that can bend without breaking will go in poly mailers just like this, and it only weighs a fraction of an ounce, so it's not making a large shipping cost. This right here, let me make sure I cover up all the addresses. There's a trading card in here. I put the trading card in a top loader in an envelope, taped it down, costs 53 cents a ship, very simple. And then finally, this is a cut to size box that I have a Blu-ray player in. So how do I do that? Well, all I do is I take a VCR like this guy that I sold right here, Panasonic PV945S. I give it two or three rolls of bubble wrap around the VCR to make sure that it's not gonna fall through the edge of the box. And then I put it in a box just like this. The trick though is you wanna make sure the box is pretty snug, and that's why I cut boxes down to size. To cut a box down to size, it is not difficult. You're gonna wanna tape one side of the box down like so, put the item in the box like so, and then with a pair of scissors, cut along the edge of the box like there. Because what you're doing basically is lowering the top of the box. Imagine these flaps right here. In order to make the box shorter, the flaps have to be smaller. So if you cut down the side of this box, the spine right there, the flaps become longer. You can score the edge with a razor to give it a nice crease like we have, right there on my boxes. You fold it over. It's got three layers of bubble wrap. It's very snug in the box. And that is going to mitigate 99% of damages you're going to get. What I do on top of that, if it costs over $100, I do buy additional insurance. And over the past year, I think I've made two insurance claims over the thousands and thousands of items I've sold. So really, it's pretty simple. That's your resale business. You want to do good accounting stuff? I have some friends who are way better at that than me. They sell an accounting spreadsheet. I will link to that below. I'll link to everything pertinent below that I may be forgetting in the video. But really, I want to instill in you, you can do this. Look at me. I just jumbled through this video in 10 minutes, and everything you have to know, I've said. I have tons of videos like this, tons of good sourcing videos, lots of helpful stuff. And if you want to become a better reseller, please subscribe and watch that video right there, because you know what? It's gonna help. I'll see you later.